Welcome to part two of Life is Strange Before the Storm Remastered with Eggers Gaming. So, let's get into it. Thanks, dude!
Screw this!
Fuck you!
Get the fuck out of here!
Fuck yes. And I forgot that if I attack him, I get punched and get a black eye. They were being dicks anyway. I fucking love this moment.
Sometimes, all I want to do is shut my eyes and tell the world to go to hell. Daily rituals are important, even when they involve writing unread letters to friends who have forgotten you.
Oh. Farrick plus Chloe, greater than Max. Thank you.
Oh yeah, that's locations and you can get it. Yeah.
Hey, Max. Hey, Dad. Another day in paradise. Right?
That, the annoying thing is, Max does not look like Max.
Last night, seeing Firewalk live, the skeevy assholes.
Yes! Fire what?
Girl. Was that really Rachel Amber?
Sorry, I'm an alarm.
You smell like cigarettes and beer. Better change clothes.
Okay. Anyway.
I'm so proud of me for winning that stupid science fair. Bask, ye mortals, in the light of the glowy bear. One of these days, I'm actually going to use you to do my homework. Ask Miss Arcadia. You're the only source of info I trust in this town. Wait, what? Who? What photo? I have feelings about this. Most of them are not good feelings.
Anyway.
That really was Rachel Amber. And she saved my life. How was last night even real? Man, I am killing it this year. Somehow I don't think Mom's going to feel the same way.
Fuck you!
Yeah, no one needs to see that. Thank you. Literally any
amount, we'll take it. Fuck yes. Why can't you be more positive? Next.
Better living through chemistry.
Fuck yes.
Wake and bake is part of a healthy breakfast.
Fuck yeah, Mr. Sharkies!
Shark babies eat their siblings in the womb.
What the fuck?
Maybe that's why I'm an only child. Used to dream of riding a unicorn as a kid. But then all the unicorns died. No more unicorns, no more princesses, and no more fucking rainbows. Nothing like a fresh start. Words of wisdom, don't fail me now.
A 100% of the shots, geniuses. Oof. Genius.
Just ask Steve Jobs.
Nice.
Mom said I was too young to go. She was wrong. And it was awesome. Max made me this mix CD years ago. And because it was Max, not a single song was pirated.
Even though it's called Pirate Power.
As awesome as some of those shows with Elliot were, they were nothing compared to Firewalk last night.
Well, I really hope it's got all the collectible things, because I got that for a fucking reason. I had it when the original.
Mom's gonna love the new look. How do I want to express my teenage angst today?
With firewalk! Ooh, bonus outfit. Oh, I'm gonna look through them all first. And I'm so glad I got the bonus outfits. Because fuck, yes! They were so cool. This one, not so much. I love the punk doe one, though. I think? Nice. I did like it, but I have the firewalk t-shirt. I have to, you know. I actually have Max's Jane Doe t-shirt. I love this outfit so fucking much. It's so cool. Oh, it's one of my favorites. Oh my god, these are new. Okay. Wait, isn't this what they wear in the... Oh my god, I think it is. Please, 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 please. Please be awesome. Oh, so cool. Sorry, I'm just geeking out here. Now for those ones, and then I'm gonna try the firewalk one. And decide from there. Ooh. Not so much. I feel like she really vibes with the tanks. Like that's classic Chloe for me. Like, come on, Chloe! I did like that one because it, but not for this. I stole for you. Okay. Firewalk. Yeah, I do love the zombie crypt ones. Ah yes, changed out of my weed stinking clothes. Time to pick up weed.
I really should get going.
Fuck yes.
Nice one, Chloe. Mom's gonna love the new look.
Like, even though, yeah, she does get a black eye, it's kind of Chloe to, like, she would.
Shit. Where's my phone? God, it's not here. How drunk was I last night?
Chloe, I said breakfast.
Guess I better try calling my phone with Mom's. Okay, Mom's phone is probably in her room. I can use it to call mine, then figure out where the hell I left it. Home, sweet home. Whoever said you can't go home again was probably from Arcadia Bay. And he could go home again. He just didn't want to.
Come on, dye your hair.
Mom's hiding her gray hair to impress her boyfriend. Maybe gray hair's his kryptonite. Maybe I should dye my hair gray. The preferred towel of Captain Bluebeard, scourge of Arcadia Bay.
I thought... I thought it was today that we got to dye it. Maybe it's tomorrow. Or the day after? I don't.
Mom's old engagement ring. Supposed to be mine, if I'm ever stupid enough to get married. Grade B? Fuck you, Arcadia Pawn. Wait, Mom's selling her engagement ring?
Please don't find a vibrator.
I hate that she hides all our old pictures of Dad. You don't deserve to be stuck in a drawer like this. I made this for Mom when I was, like, 10 years old. If she wore it now, I'm not sure which of us would be more embarrassed. I should call my phone.
God, what was in there?
Ah, Mom. Bad enough that David comes here for dinner.
Dude, put it in the fucking bin. It's not that far.
Mom's finally making her bed again? I guess that's a good sign. I want Mom to be happy, but not like this. Not like this! Sometimes you have to get knocked down lower than you've ever been to stand up taller than you ever were. Blech. Don't give up on yourself. A single spark can start a fire that burns the entire prairie better.
What, just because you like fires? What? What does that mean?
How can Mom look at this every day and not see what a tool she's dating? Sounds like my phone is definitely nearby. There we go. Wonder how many calls I've missed.
We know this! The game tells us it a lot. What about a jar? No, later. I'm reading weird.
Chloe, breakfast! Bring my purse down with you, please.
Yeah. Okay.
I think I saw Mom's purse in her room. I should take that down to Mom.
Fucking do it already!
Oh, can you grab my cell phone too?
Yes, Mother.
I need to talk to you.
Yeah, that really makes me want to hurry.
To me, it doesn't look that different in graphics, but it's possible I'm having rose-tinted glasses. And plus we get more. I don't even care.
You can put my purse on the dining table. You might still have time for breakfast if you hurry.
Or I could just fucking not eat because yay! No, that's me. Issues with eating. Yay!
David's here so early. Mom calls him just a friend, but look at him. He's pretending he didn't just spend the night. And you never saw the condoms, Chloe. You never saw the condoms. Dad took these photos. Now that David's staying over so much, I wonder how long it'll take Mom to shove them in a drawer somewhere.
Chloe, I don't have all day. Would you get over here already?
I should see.
Fuck off, I want to explore.
Wow. Sean Prescott's son Nathan goes to my school. Sounds like the apple didn't fall far from the asshole.
Wait, what?
Why do I suddenly want to get some fireworks?
Oh, shit.
Mom doesn't want me to know, but it's pretty clear her boy toy, David, hasn't worked in like a year. Any letter from Blackwell is never good. Is Mom having trouble with payments again? My scholarship doesn't cover everything. Like I need another reason for Principal Wells to get on my case. Aren't you glad you left for Seattle, Max? And never looked back?
No.
Aren't you glad you left for Seattle? Family pic used to hang here. Wow. I can't actually remember which one. Dad always talked about upgrading to a flat screen. Too bad that never happened. I would have gotten this bad boy in my room. Hard to believe I was an eighth grade science athlete. Did I peak in middle school? It's my job to water these plants, but it was Dad's job to remind me, so. Nobody's fault, really. From when Max and I spilled Mom's wine. I think the only reason Mom hasn't recarpeted is so she can stay mad at me. We're already supporting one. Thanks. Made that for Mom in an art class when I was like 5. She was never a smoker, but it's cool. I was never an artist.
Sorry.
Wait, those aren't Mom's keys. And these would be David's keys. There's probably a better place for them than the ashtray I made Mom. Like his home, maybe?
Oh, Max. Or Rachel. Depending on how you see it.
Little dude's like, what the hell just happened? Dad's old swear jar. We spent the last of his curses on bus fare and milk. How can bacon smell so good, but I'd still rather stuff these sugar bombs in my mouth? Pot roast? Mom hates pot roast. It's not that I'm ungrateful. It's just that when your mom works in a diner, you're not always in the mood for diner-type food.
Hello.
You wanted to talk?
Chloe, what happened to you?
It's no big deal. I walked into a door.
You seem to be walking into a lot of doors lately. When I send you a text message, Chloe, like last night, I need you to answer.
You can just say text. You don't have to say message.
And I need you to answer without the snark.
Sorry. I hear you. I'll do better about replying.
Thank you.
Is that what you wanted to talk about?
What is it with you and David? Always cutting to the chase. Why can't we just have some pleasant conversation before school?
Okay. Pot roast, exchange drink, David.
You can have a no
something.
Thank you helping.
No, you hate pot roast. I don't care.
I don't hate it. And David likes it. And don't say you don't care.
So that's what we're doing now? Whatever your boyfriend likes? Are you selling your engagement ring?
Chloe, jewelry gets appraised for all sorts of reasons. Like for insurance.
Nice dodge.
How about this? You don't go in my bedroom when I'm not there.
How about you don't ask me to get your damn purse then? Ah, right. School. My favorite.
You used to love to learn.
Yeah. I used to think drugs were lame too.
I wish you wouldn't joke like that.
Joke?
You do realize I hate your boyfriend with every fiber of my being, right?
Chloe! You don't hate him.
He calls me girly. He's a dickhole.
He can be old-fashioned.
Yeah, an old-fashioned dickhole.
Let's not fight. I made you breakfast.
Nah, I'll just grab something later.
Oh, you'll enjoy this. The other day I made 4 eggs, 2 for David, 2 for me. And just before I served them, he says, what are you gonna eat?
I'll enjoy that, huh?
Firewall? Is that the band you mentioned last week?
I'm still bummed you wouldn't let me go.
Mm-hmm.
What?
I know what time you came home last night. And don't think you can get out of school just because you missed the bus again.
Why would you assume that?
Who do you think your principal calls when you skip? Do you think I enjoy lying for you, saying you're sick just so you don't get expelled? And I do know what pot smells like, you know. Between your grades and your disregard for my rules, I see you slipping. I'm worried.
But Mom, the whole point of lowering expectations is so you won't be disappointed in me. Ever again.
You're happy doing what you're doing? Fine. Keep at it. Just let me know so I can stop fighting with Blackwell to keep you on scholarship. Money's tight enough as it is.
Maybe David should start paying rent. He spends the night often enough.
How would you know? You're never here yourself. David thinks you need discipline.
David should mind his own business.
He's not.
I think it's great David's taking an interest.
Her dad.
He's a good man. Maybe he can help.
Dad was a good man.
That's not fair. I'm glad your father still has a place in your heart. But sometimes we need to make more room in our hearts for new people.
And sometimes, when we're incredibly desperate and lonely, we choose the absolute wrong kind of people to let into our hearts. Mom.
David's had some hard times too, you know. If he's kind enough to share his experience, I expect you to listen.
Like I'd let him get within 15 feet of me.
When he takes you to school today.
Very funny.
You will be nice, you will be respectful, and you will say thank you.
Are you serious?
Nope.
This is such...
What, Chloe? Such what?
Mom's trying, I guess. Maybe I should too. But what's the point in getting along if it means pretending everything's fine when it's not? You want me to pretend I'm okay with David? That everything's okay? I'm not. He's a chauvinistic piece of shit, frankly, and...
If your father could hear you...
No, you're right. I'm sure Dad and the mustache would get along great. It's a big bed. There's room enough for all three of you.
That's enough. All
you, David, done the urn.
A little respect. Why is that too much? I love you, Chloe. I miss you. Nobody could have replaced your father. I did the best I could.
Mom.
I don't know where I lost you.
You didn't lose me.
Right. David's waiting. He'll need the keys. They're in that ashtray you made me. Go be his problem now.
Bringing David his keys is about the most humiliating thing Mom could ask me to do.
Ew.
No point in putting off the inevitable torture of driving to school with David. I'd better get going.
Let's go.
Thank you for watching, and I will be back with the next episode very soon. Thank you very much, and see you, bitches!